Right, here we go. And Mr. Starter Ian Storer gives them the green, and it is 4:34. Dave McCrudden who takes them away down the home straight for the first time. A little bit too fast into that first corner. Let's see if he survives the early melee as we go racing in eight number one, leading the yellow top charge on the home on the back straight is the fast driver 22 William Yarrow, and now he's beginning to challenge for the lead. The new leader on the home straight is 4:21 Nigel Wilkinson, but here comes Yarrow now at the wheel of his folding car. Bumper goes in tight on the inside line, and the yellow top now leads. McCrudden always getting it a little bit wrong there, allowing the white top to get back on terms. It's 22 leading from 4:21 Nigel Wilkinson in that second place. And it looks like, I think it's Mark Ford in car 57, now moving into second position himself. It's folding cars in first and second positions. Then comes the third of the yellow tops, 2:15, Jeff Nichols, as we're awaiting the charge of the star grey drivers from the back of the grid. Leading those through turns 3 and 4 at the moment is 5:15 Frankie Wayman Jr. As he's looking for a way past 98 Les Spencer. It's 22 your leader, there he is through turns 3 and 4, ahead of car 57 in second place. Then comes 2:15 Jeff Nichols, and up to fourth now is 2:65 Rob Ratzel on the home straight. Into the top six goes 5:15 Frankie Wayman Jr. as 2:03 Danny Clark has to retire to the infield. 22 Will Yarrow still leading as we have to bring out the yellows, and the cause of the race suspension is the number five car of Johnny Goodall. Number five Johnny Goodall is embedded in the fence on turn three, and obviously just need to check on the condition of that driver before we return to racing. So as we anticipate the start, look for the resume of racing from Will Yarrow, but the anticipated charge from 515 Frankie Wayman Jr. And away we go, clean and green. Jr. now up the inside of 265 Rob Bradsell on the home straight. Into fifth position he goes, into fourth. Throws that car wide. Puts the power down early and now begins the chase after the top three yellow tops. 22 Will Yarrow, 57 Mark Ball gets put up on a tyre thanks to 215 Jeff Nichols, and that consequently elevates Junior into third place. Again, late onto the brakes into turns one and two. Looking for the inside line now on 215 Jeff Nichols. A slight touch on the bumper. On the inside line, Nichols desperately tries to hold out the superstar as they go down the home straight once again, and now Junior moves into second. Oh, but he's been taken out by Nichols in a real surprise move that looked an absolute carbon copy of a near destruction at this year's semi-final, and it's caused the pile-up, taking out 98 Jeff Nichols, 98 Les Spencer, and 188. And here they come, and 22, Will Yarrow, there he is, on the back straight. He survived that chaos, almost unscathed, and is back in the lead by a comfortable margin now, ahead of 77 Ian Platts in second. In third is 265 Rob Bradsell. Fourth is 212 Frankie Wayman. And in fifth now, from the back of the grid, is 213 Des Chandler. And there goes Yarrow again. So that was a shock challenge by 215 Jeff Nichols. He had one shot at the tail end of 515 Frankie Wayman Jr. and that was all he needed. Jr. always on the limits of adhesion, only needed that little extra push, and he was into a half spin on turns one and two, and that allowed 22 William Yarrow to say thanks very much, and away he went clear. There he is on the home straight into turns one and two again, comfortably clear ahead of 77 Ian Platts in second. 265 Rob Ratzel is third, but now is coming under attack from 213 Des Chandler. Chandler now challenging as we approach the back straight, and he's trying to get up the inside of 265 Rob Ratzel. It's 22 your leader, 77 Ian Platts beginning to close him down in second place, but still some way off the lead. Up to third now goes 213 Des Chandler. In fourth is 265 Rob Bradsell. Then comes 212 Frankie Wayman Sr. And back into the frame in sixth place after that challenge from Nichols is the superstar 515 Frankie Wayman Jr. Is anybody out there, though, going to be fast enough to catch Yarrow as we go through to the closing stages of heat number one? The lap boards are out. And there's Junior chasing his father into turns three and four, shoves his dad wide, and now begins the challenge 265 at Rob Bradsell. But it's going to be checkered flag, this time on the home straight. It's going to be a flag-to-flag victory almost. 422 William Yarrow, he wins ahead of 77 Ian Platts in second. Coming home third will be 213 Des Chandler, and in fourth is 212 Frankie Wayman Sr. as all hell let loose on that final corner as 515 Frankie Wayman Jr. pushed it far too hard once again, tangled out with veteran 265 Rob Bradsell, and has consequently absolutely nothing to show for his efforts. He will have to try all over again in tonight's consolation race. No doubt about the winner, though. In car 22, it was the flying yellow top, Will Yarrow. So there he goes, with the Frankie Wayman style wave of the checkered flag, the winner of heat number one tonight, 22, Will Yarrow. For 64 Jamie Davidson, 97 is Murray Harrison from Kettering. For 22 is Shen Stones and Nigel Wharton. Then we have the pole position starter for next weekend's World Championship Final, 64 Kev Smith. Then it's for Daniel Harter. 391 is Andy Smith, 41 Gareth Bott, and we're about to go green. Away we go, racing in heat two. There's Paul Pennington trying to get the first drop into turns one. There goes 382. 99, Graham Bird about to get tangled out with some of the white tops, and he's off onto the infield already. 382 is your leader from 121. Chris Wilkinson getting into a bit of bother there, and so are some of the stalwarts on the back straight. And the red top's trying to force their way through as the two old boys, 208 Martin Fernhoff and 327 Howard Davis, go out. So it's 382 your leader at the moment. From 121 Chris Wilkinson in second place. Then in third is the first yellow top, 424 Mike Haywood. Then comes number six, Phil Wilton. Then 26 Ray Williams as 21 Mark Gilback spins off onto the infield. The lead in the red tops is 97 Murray Harrison ahead of 64 Kev Smith. There's your lead car, 382. Paul Pennington with him for company is flat down man 38 Jason Holden. The second and third place man get tangled out. Recovering first is 424 Mike Haywood, but he's a long way behind Pennington at the moment. And the back marker, 38 Jason Holden, puts the bumper in. And now into turns at one and two, and approaching the back straight, the first of the red tops are beginning to come into the picture. There goes 97 Murray Harrison, and he's put right into the fence there, courtesy of 64 Kev Smith, in a shower of sparks and a backfiring engine, and 64 Kev Smith on the home straight, now leading the red tops, although he goes wide and it could be due to a flat tyre. And 391 Andy Smith says thank you very much and takes up the running as far as the red tops are concerned. But he's a long, long, long way back as far as 382 Paul Pennington is concerned. And there he is, into turns three and four goes the white top. And how much longer can he hold on? If the way he goes on is going to continue, it could be all the way to the flag. Holden, though, still looking to unlap himself. And there he goes. Oh, well, they're beginning to tangle. Leaning on one another quite drastically there. And 38 passes him. And it remains to be seen as we approach the start marshal on the approach to the home straight, whether the 38 car is indeed your leader. No clear indication there, and I still get it as 3-8-2. Paul Pennington has the lead car in heat number two. In second place and beginning to close is the Star Train, headed by 3-9-1 Andy Smith, ahead of 4-6-4 Jamie Davidson. Then comes 41 Gareth Bott and 4-2-2 Nigel Wharton. And we'll just check the charts again as we go through to complete another lap. And as indicated by Mr. Starter, it is 38. Jason Holden, your race leader in Heat 2, ahead of 3-8-2 Paul Pennington, the white top in second place from Manchester. In third now, and closing, is Rochdale's 3-9-1 Andy Smith. Then comes 4-6-4 Jamie Davidson, 4-2-2 Nigel Wharton, and 41 Gareth Bott. Those are your lead drivers in Heat 2, and 38 Jason Holden is beginning to get caught up with some of those back markers, principally 26 Ray Williams. And here comes the charge from Andy Smith now. Puts the bumper in on the white top Pennington, tight inside on turns 3 and 4 he goes, and now begins to close on Holden. And now has a realistic chance of beginning to claim top honours in race 2 tonight. It's 38 your leader from 3-9-1 Andy Smith in second place. Then comes 4-64 Jamie Davidson, 3-8-2 Paul Pennington beginning to slip down the field as the lap boats are out for 38 Jason Holden. Pennington now, after a good drive, begins to slip down the places and it's now been passed by 4-2-2 Nigel Wharton. Just a few more laps left, and 38 Jason Holden has to try and counter these back markers, and he passes 4-10 Paul Lowe in the proceedings into turns 1 and 2 once again, as 3-9-1 Andy Smith, your second place man, begins to smoke as he releases off the accelerator into the corners. There he goes again, and 38 still has it and sees another lap board left. Oh, and number 4 Daniel Arthur goes absolutely airborne there, and there's a little bit of debris on the track. And it's going to be checkered flag this time, and 38 Jason Holden has indeed done enough to hold on. It's 38 Jason Holden who wins heat number 2 tonight, ahead of 3-9-1 Andy Smith in second place. In third was 4-6-4 Jamie Davidson. Fourth over the line was 4-22 Nigel Wharton. Then came 41 Gareth Bott, and after a good drive, 3-8-2 Paul Pennington. Just purely observations at this stage. We'll confirm those results on screen. But the race win went to the Yellow Top. Another B-grade win tonight for 38, Jason Holden. And as I speak, would you believe the late arrival in the pits is none other than 53, John Lund. And there he goes, looking delighted with checkered flag aloft, recording his second Yellow Top victory tonight. And that's 38, Jason Holden. Green flag drops this time, and let's go racing in Heat 3. Down the home straight for the first time, your leader is number 7, Phil Bicknell. 4-06, Paul Johnson follows him through. Then comes 3-8-9. As 5-07, Neil Smith goes into a spin on the approach to the back straight. Leading the red tops at the moment is 2-5-0, Keith Chambers on the far side. And he's swiftly followed through by the rest of the red tops. Number 14, Roger Bromley, in trouble already. And on the back straight is number 7, Phil Bicknell leading. Just look at the amount of bumper work going through, courtesy of those red tops. So in the early stages of heat number 3, really beginning to push and shove their way through. And one of the yellow tops has gone to the fence on the far side. And just look at the bumper work going in there, thanks to 96 Clint Daft. Lying in third place is car 96 now. Look at the inside line on 4-0-6, Paul Johnson. He indeed gets that place and now begins to chase after your race leader, number 7, Phil Bicknell. It's 7 from 96, 4-0-6. Oh, and the blue top's really pressing the self-destruct button there. And 34 Mel Brown goes to the wires on turn 2. And still Phil Bicknell has it. Here he goes into turns 1 and 2 once again. And 53, John Lund has encountered trouble, and he gets back into the action, a lap down. Beginning to make progress in car 343, that's Barry Heath. And woe betide anyone trying to get past this hard-charging driver from the West Midlands. Then comes 48, Neil Scoggan. I described him to be Alan on the lineup, but it is indeed Neil in car 48. And the race leaders are being hampered by the back markers on the far side now. Let's see who's going to come through with all this unscathed. Well, Colin Nairn is certainly not one of them in 8-0. He's parked up on the approach on the back straight, and the leaders are now coming through in the form of 3-4-3, Barry Heath. Right behind him comes 96, Lynn Daft. 48, Neil Scullin pushing and shoving his way through, and has got the better of Daft indeed there. Look out for Daft coming back here into turns 1 and 2 again. The bumper goes in. 3-7-1, Shane Durrell looking for the inside line. He gets it, moves into third place, but he's hampered a little bit by the chassis work of the 96 car, and that's allowed number one, Peter Balding, the opportunity he wanted to really put his charge through. And here he is on the home straight, puts the bumper in on 3-7-1, Shane Durrell. Number two, Paul Harrison, is hot on his heels. And here they all are. Now the race is really beginning to explode at this, the halfway stage, with the Union Jack being shown by Mr. Starter. It's 3-4-3, Barry Heath, your race leader. Here he is into turns 1 and 2 once again, and really clouts the back marker 137, Andy Jacklin, in no uncertain terms. And in that melee, 48, Neil Scoggan goes into the dike on the infield. He is out of the action. And Peter Balding now relentlessly pursues his prey in the shape of 3-7-1, Shane Durrell. Looks for the inside line. Here goes the bumper once again. The blue top desperately tries to hold out, but it's to no avail. And the world champion, number one, Peter Balding, who will be defending that title next Saturday night at the Arsenal Stadium, Bradford, now finds himself in second position. It's 3-4-3 from number one. Then comes 3-7-1, Shane Durrell. Number two, Paul Harrison, now mounts his challenge. And right behind those two comes number 73, Rob Cowley. The battle will now commence for the lead, as into turns 1 and 2 goes 3-4-3, Barry Heath, and number 1, Peter Balding. But just look at number 2, Paul Harrison there. Really throw the bumper in very, very late indeed on 3-7-1, Shane Durrell. And Durrell is far from finished here, still in a very competitive place. And he's really caught up with the race leaders. 3-4-3, Barry Heath, and 1, Peter Balding. And the first three are all together into turns 1 and 2 once more. And now Peter Balding with a challenge. It pays off this time. He takes up the lead, and Durrell now challenges for second. The sparks fly, and he, oh, has he tangled? He has indeed, and that's put curtains to Durrell's challenge, but he's managed to survive it. 3-4-3, Barry Heath now regains that second position behind the world champion. And this has clearly been the best race of the night so far, as the floodlights have come on fully, and the racing looks discerningly quicker in the floodlights. It's number one, Peter Balding, ahead of the two blue tops, battling for that second place. 3-4-3, Barry Heath, and 3-7-1, Shane Durrell. Then comes number two, Paul Harrison. 73, Rob Park Cowley, and 2-5-0, Keith Chambers. And it's checkered flag this time. Number one, Peter Balding, in all the action and all the excitement. 16 laps have been completed. He heads home, the second place man, 3-4-3, Barry Heath. In third, after a superb drive, was 3-7-1, Shane Durrell. Then came number two, Paul Harrison, and 2-5-0, Keith Chambers behind 73, Rob Cowley. Those were your top six finishers in heat number three, and the man who came out on top was the world champion, number one, Peter Balding. The world champion to make the first star grade victory of the night. And looking as calm and as casual as ever with the checkered flag, it's number one, Peter Balding. And away we go racing in tonight's consolation. And 4:34, Dave McCrudden is the first one. Sorry, Peter McCrudden is the first one to show into turns one and two, ahead of the brothers Grumble. And it's Chris that leads Nigel. All hell breaking loose on the far side, and 2:08, Haas is the boss, Ferryhoe getting into all sorts of trouble there, and that's allowed the whole battery of star men to move on through ahead of him. Here's your leader though, spinning out the 507 car of Neil Smith, and puts far too much power down in the process, and puts paid to his own chances. That's Pete McCrudden in 434, and it's Wilkinson, 421, who's leading. Into turns 3 and 4 he goes, into a spin and out of it, and that's now allowed 344 Tony Brown to lead it down the home straight, and all sorts of chaos is breaking loose right the way around this tight little oval as everybody desperately tries to look to lead the pack. And again on turns 3 and 4, a big pile-up taking place and everybody begin to bore and shove their way through. One of the casualties was 34 Mal Brown. As I get it at this moment, it's Tony Brown in 3.44 on the back straight who leads it, ahead of 1.21, Chris Wilkinson in second. Then comes 4.24, Mike Haywood, 3.29, Richard Brighton, 48, Neil Scollin. And 3.78, Wayne Andley. Further back, the red tops beginning to make their way through the field. I think 1.72, Stephen Hodgson, could be a lap down. If not, he's certainly made very, very swift progress indeed into the top six places. That's the 172 car into turns 3 and 4 now. Steve Hodgson at the wheel. Oh, and he really has put paid to his chances now as he spins out on that turn. And consequently, all the red tops getting into all sorts of bother there. Trying to make his way through is 53 John Lund, and he goes through down the home straight and into turns 1 and 2. And we're looking to try and thread our way through with the leaders. Where on earth are they? Tony Brown in 3.44 is coming to trouble, as is 4.24 Mike Haywood, and they were in the higher places a few laps earlier on. And so, as I can see now, 1-2-1, Chris Wilkinson into turns 3 and 4 is your leader, but he has consequently been passed by 98 Les Spencer. And we're checking our lap positions with Mr. Starter, and he is indicating 3-2-9 Richard Brighton and 48 Neil Scotland to be. Oh, and we've got a rollover right in front of us, and 98 Les Spencer is hit cab sidewards as he spins out over onto his roof he went with 406 Paul Johnson. And that was quite dramatic stuff here in the consolation race. And as we've already... Here comes more action, and away we go racing, and Kev Smith doesn't waste any time at all and sweeps into that second place. Look at the progress of 515 Frankie Wayman Jr. up the inside of Haas Ferryhoe. He's nearly tangled there, but that was quite close, and now he pursues after 53 John Lund. It's 3-2-9 Richard Brighton thumps in the bumper on one of the back markers. 64 Kev Smith is right behind him now, looming large in his mirrors. In third is 48 Neil Scodden on the back straight. Then comes 53 John Lund, 116 Kevin Clare, and 515 Frankie Wayman Jr. And here comes Kev Smith with the challenge. Although, just look at Neil Scodden on the back end of Kev Smith. And has Kev Smith got some sort of problem with that car? The leaders approaching the home straight once more. Here they come. It's 3-2-9. Richard Brighton beginning to lengthen up quite a nice little lead ahead of 64 Kev Smith. And again the bumper goes in thanks to the yellow top 48 Neil Scholder. And his impetuosity is quite unabounded. Kev Smith really having a race on his hands for that second place. And this is allowing 53 John Lund to close him down. And so too does 515 Frankie Wayman Jr. It's 3-2-9 Richard Brighton with it all to play for ahead of 64 Kev Smith. And into third place now goes 53 John Lund. And 48 Neil Scudden receives a big one from 515 Frankie Wainman Jr. Richard Brighton now holding out a trio of star men. And Kev Smith is quite clearly slightly slower than the rest of them. And 53 John Lund is beginning to close and battle for that second place. And the lap boards are out. Less than five laps remain in the consolation. And it's all to play for once more as the three red top drivers begin to close down the long-time leading blue top, 3-2-9 Richard Brighton. And here comes the attack from Kev Smith. Brighton going wide there, Kev Smith eyes inside, elbows aside the 3-2-9 car, and Smith now leads the consolation race. Back goes the bumper, we're going to see it, Brighton, and will he play off here? And it's neck and neck, and the blue top gets him back, and the checker flag drops, and just look at Kev Smith take out Junior Wainman as they cross the line, locked together. It was an absolutely classic return from 3-2-9 Richard Brighton at the very death into turns 3 and 4 on the very, very last lap of racing. He booked the bumper in quite superbly on Kev Smith. Kev Smith had nowhere to go but fencewards. He locked horns again with Brighton. It was to no avail. The blue top came across the line in first as Junior Wainman and Kev Smith locked up together and crossed the line together. What an absolutely hectic conclusion to a brilliant consolation race tonight here at Stoke. So there he is, everyone, the man winning an absolutely sensational consolation race victory here tonight at the Stoke Auto Speedway. This guy really knows how to use the front bumper and to excellent effect. It's 3-2-9 Richard Brighton. And we're about to go racing with the first of the star men is number two, Paul Harrison, and 4-2-2 Nigel Wharton. 4-6-4 is Jamie Davison. 2-5-0 Keith Chambers, 77 Ian Platts. 4-6-4 Jamie Davison, your superstars are number one Peter Faulding, and 5-1-5 Frankie Wainman Jr. and 53 John Lund. But we're already well away into the first few laps of the event, and the 3-9-6 card of Jason Cronshaw has already gone out, and surprise surprise, would you believe it, your lead man is 22 Will Yarrow. 79 Neil Long gets back into the action as the leader comes down the home straight for the second time of asking. He leads in 22 ahead of 38 Jason Holden in second place. Then comes the 96 Glyn Daft, 382 Paul Pennington, 205 is Jeff Nichols, and then goodness me, just look at the charge from the red tops, and leading the way is 422 Nigel Wharton, already into the top six. Number two, Paul Harrison, bounces his way through onto the home straight under a distinct degree of pressure from 4-6-4, Jamie Davidson, and 77 Ian Platts. Number two is forced wide, slips down the places just a little bit as the leaders come through down the home straight once again, and the whole gaggle of them all together. And 22 and 38 are locked in battle. And here they are on the back straight. In third is 96 Lynn Daft. Fourth now is 382 Paul Pennington, and who's spun out there on the far side? It is indeed Yarrow who has gone, and 38 Jason Holden finds himself desperately trying to hang on to the lead. In spite of this, 96 Clint Daff gets involved with 77 Ian Platts, and 4-6-4 Jamie Davidson is really riding on a crest of a wave here. In third place at the moment, but surely not for too much longer. Tries to get on the inside of 96 Glyn Daft. Down the home straight he goes. In the inside of the yellow top, The other top tries to come back on him here, late into the corner on turns one and two. And 4.64, Altrincham's Jamie Davidson is really finding good Shale form tonight, and is very, very close behind the leader in that second position. It's 38 from 4.64 into turns one and two. Then comes 77 Ian Platts, who won the final here on semi-final day in July. Then comes 5.15 Frankie Wayman Jr., number two Paul Harrison, and at numero uno Peter Faulding. And now the red top train is really beginning to make its presence felt, and all hell breaks loose there as 4.64 Jamie Davidson goes wide and is put out by Jason Holden in car 38 in a real on with arm manoeuvre, and that put paid to both of their chances. Your lead is now with 77 Ian Platts. Onto the home straight he comes with 5.15 Frankie Wayman Jr. really begin to bear down on him. Lying in wait in number one, Peter Faulding lying in third position now as the red top train proceeds in this, the grand final here at the Stoke Auto Speedway tonight. 77 Ian Platts looking for another final victory if he can hold out the attentions of 5.15 Frankie Wayman Jr. We reach the halfway stage of this race, and the question is which of these drivers are going to come out on top as they seek to pass 4.64 Jamie Davidson. 1 minute he was challenging for the lead, next minute he's trying to get through. Oh, and 77 Ian Platts just about managed to scrape off there as he left his lunge very, very late indeed as he tried to pass the 4.64 car. It came off, and 5.15 Frankie Wayman Jr. is still really breathing hot down his exhaust pipe. Here comes the challenge, into turns one and two, breaking late, and he puts him into the parked car. A fantastic move there by Junior Wayman. And 77 Ian Platts is left high and dry, but will Junior hang on here? Because here comes the challenge from the 1993 world champion number one Peter Faulding. Indeed, just a little bit of breathing space between himself and the world champion. It's 5.15 and number one on the back straight. In third is two Paul Harrison, fourth is 1.09 Phil Smith. In fifth now is 77 Ian Platts, then comes 3.71 Shane Durrell, and Wayman now begins to break a little bit of a gap between himself and Peter Faulding, putting the power down where it counts. He breaks away from the world champion into turns three and four once again and onto the home straight. John Lund in 53 began to make a late charge. Some way off the placings at the moment, but should they get into the top 10 as we come to 20 laps of racing? But still a good number of laps left, and Peter Faulding most certainly has not given up the fight. Hayu and Wayman there a little bit hampered by the back marker 250 Keith Chambers, and number one Peter Faulding closes him down quite significantly. The marker boards are out. There's five laps left or so for Junior Wayman in 5.15. Peter Faulding right behind him, just two car lengths behind in car number one. Now Peter Faulding begins to put himself really into top gear, quite mentally, if he's going to put a 100% challenge here on Wayman before the checkered flag drops. And it's going to be too late. Here comes the checkered flag, and 5.15 Frankie Wayman Jr. takes an emphatic grand final victory. Peter Faulding could do absolutely nothing about it. Coming home third was two Paul Harrison, then came 1.09 Phil Smith, 77 Ian Platts, and 53 John Lund. Just purely observations at this stage, but it was really a race-long duel between two of the top three drivers in the sport of Brisker Formula One stock cars, and the man who made it on the night was 5.15 Frankie Wayman Jr. Here he comes then, the winner of tonight's Formula One Grand Final, 515 Frankie Wayman Jr. He's certainly been in the wars tonight, being taken out in his heat, being taken across the grass by Kev Smith in the consolation. But he survived it all, smiling right the way around. He began to come on top, and he won the Grand Final.